Hello, 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 ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to a Saturday day into the evening and into the night stream with the iRacing Sebring 12 hours. We are just going live as we are preparing for qualifying that is due to start at 1:30, so in 14 minutes time. And we'll see how we do in terms of this race. Going to be racing with Hydro Racing Geodesic Racing, the iRacing team that I'm a part of, and we've got a familiar voice. I almost said face, but obviously you don't really get to see Nath's face. But I've done numerous races with Nath, and us two are going to be two-manning this race, just the two of us. So it should be good fun and an entertaining race. We're just basically just hoping to try and keep things clean, try and make it to the end and see where we end up when it comes to the checker flag after 12 hours of racing. Hi to Pulse, hello to you, good to see you here in the chat already. And the others of you who are lingering, please do say hi. Hope you're doing all good and your week's been fun and has all gone well. And hopefully your weekend goes just as well too. But yeah, excited for this race to see how it goes. That's what I was going to do. I was going to try and figure out what split we're actually in. So bear with me one very quick moment whilst I figure this out. Geo Black. Session 593. So, as always with these events, they are quite big. There we go, some one. Alright, looks like we're in fourth split in the end. So some fairly big teams here in this race, which is just pretty cool. Some sim racing teams, esports teams, so some pretty fierce competition, I would have thought. But at the moment, running some race lap times here in this practice session, and things look fairly good. We're in the kind of the middle of the pack, but it looks like a few people are starting to set their qualifying times already, so it'll be interesting to see how that actually goes when it comes around to that session. And Vital, my week has been okay. Work has been good. However, unfortunately for us, me and Alice, the gearbox on the car that me and her have is basically dead. So we've been trying to sort that out with the garage and warranty company, because we bought the car last year, back at the start of 2022, and the car should be effectively covered under warranty. But yeah, that got approved yesterday, so thankfully the claim is going through, and we are getting a new gearbox and clutch, which is good. It's just a frustrating process, because it's taken about a week and a half just to come to that conclusion. Really annoying, and it's not really anything to do with me and Alice. I noticed that something wasn't quite right with the car when I first picked it up, and the Ford mechanics kind of waved it off and said, "Nah, it's fine. You're okay." Yeah, it seems like the issue has gone considerably worse over the course of the year, and has gone to the point where in need of a new gearbox and clutch. The previous owner was a Motability owner, so they had some sort of disability. Don't really know what that use. It's not too common that Motability owners get manual gearbox cars. And we thought we were getting a relatively good deal, but of course we don't know how they've driven the car, and evidently it seems like they've been quite heavy with the clutch and gearbox, and put quite a bit of excessive wear, because the car's done less than 30,000 miles. Car that was registered in 2018, so it's pretty new. fairly modern and recent, and obviously shouldn't be having the issues that it is here at this point. But nonetheless, hopefully we get the car back this coming week. But we have Sebring now to attend with and have some fun. So let's bring the game up, because Naif has gone back in. So do is undeafen. Hello, we are back.
Oh, hi.
Hello, hello. Hopefully, in a very short moment, let's change the setup and we'll get ourselves out on track. There we go. Alright, you okay with me doing some laps?
Yes, mate, crack on. I was just trying to watch you really get onto your YouTube.
Ah, cool. Thank you.
Thanks, Ryan. Hope you're well, mate.
Yeah, cheers, Ryan. Good to see you always tune in every now and then.
I haven't seen him for ages, mate.
Yeah, likewise. And my training paint is having some good fun at the moment. Ah, there we go. Loaded up our paint finally.
Oh no, he got married, didn't he?
Ryan did get married.
Has he had a baby?
I don't know. Ryan, have you had a baby? What esports team is he racing with? Because he's one of the bigger ones now, isn't he?
I can't remember what he was in one, wasn't he? He's done quite a lot of Apex. Oh, congratulations, mate. Excuse my kids.
Helicopter.
Okay.
Brilliant.
When I jumped it.
Oh, you have to be quiet, or I should put Matt off and it crashed.
Okay. Well, congratulations on the baby, Ryan.
There's Matt there.
It's good to hear. Shame you're not racing this year, but obviously family comes first. Good to look after them. And it's pretty cool sharing the track with you at Petit Le Mans last year as well,
iPad?
When I was doing that solo.
What's your iPad? And I'll put Matt on your iPad.
Why?
You can watch us race.
Oh yeah.
Harry likes that.
How'd you get onto YouTube?
www.youtube.com.
It's got the app, right?
Yeah, click on the YouTube app then.
No,
indeed, there was also
key.
Watkins. Yeah, this car's fun under braking. Quite easy to snap brake.
Watch him now.
Gonna have to be careful with the language now, aren't I? Good watching.
Mate, I wouldn't worry about that. He must be worse than me. No, he's not, actually. I'll clarify that up on the screen.
Oh, dear me.
Was it satellite racing that he was with?
can't remember.
Ryan, who did you used to race with?
Hey, JR. Yeah, they probably were doing some rally racing.
Someone in my mind's telling me satellite. Right, how long we got? 4 minutes.
Copy that. We're also in split two, by the way.
Split two?
Sorry, four, not two.
Jesus.
I don't know why I said two.
Fucking scared me then, mate. But what?
Nah, split four.
Who's going on the hard compound tyres?
Final sector.
Yeah, I just see that. What was that? Was that third or fourth?
I think third on the entry and then fourth.
I've been finding fourth all the way around actually better for myself.
Fourth is okay if I can get it, make sure I actually get it tucked into the apex.
Yeah. If you get it hooked up, fourth seems to just give you a bit more traction and it's not so loose.
Yeah.
And you can hammer on the throttle. He's talking to you on his iPad.
Oh, is he?
Yeah, Matt, that's why my dad talks all the time.
Ah.
Not actually talking, he's just talking to you on the iPad, like voice. As if you can hear him.
I can't hear you, Harry. You're going to have to speak up, mate. I can make out some of the words that you're saying. I know you keep saying my dad.
What was you saying? He can't see your iPad, has he? Can't see my screens.
Actually, I can see you right here. Like, literally, you have to come through this corner.
Yes? Yep.
Yeah. What gear should I be using in that corner?
He said, what gear should I be using in that corner?
Yeah, because you have to slow down when you're going back to the corner. And when you're going for this corner, what? Because you nearly crashed into that car.
Yeah, I'll make sure to keep clear of the
other
cars.
Don't sit over there, then. No, Hatch, you can't sit on my lap, mate.
That's very sweet of him. Right, 8:30.
Yeah, I'm going to go for a cigarette quick, mate.
All right, see you in a sec, then.
Good luck in qualifying, mate.
Okay, cheers. Right, qualifying is just about to start. So we shall get that underway and hopefully we can get ourselves into a reasonable position. You should be able to see up in the top left-hand corner. I've got some additional UI for you guys so you can make sure and, you know, get a better idea as to what's going on in the race. A little bit more info for you and a bit clearer in terms of the standings. So hopefully that all works well. And thank you very much, Vital. Right. See how we can do in qualifying here. We do have one out lap before we get our two flying laps. Hopefully everything's all good in terms of the stream quality and all that. Sound is there. Video looking all nice and smooth, I hope. Just caught the break. So easy to do. Especially when the tyres still aren't quite up to temperature. So that's obviously this lap invalidated. Let's see what we can do on the next one. It's usually the quicker of the two anyway. Much, much smoother. Bit of an awkward curve there. One corner to go though. And a new PB.
There's the flag, it's over.
Nice lap, mate, nice lap.
Thanks. Probably would have been a tenth or so quicker if I didn't catch that curb.
Yeah, that last bit coming into the Levac straight.
Yeah.
Just chucked the car around, I was watching from behind. Really unsettled it, and then you missed the apex on the right hander. Mate, it's three of us all within the same tenth.
Jesus.
No, four of us. Jesus Christ. Yeah, there. Oh.
That's really weird, because it didn't even drop over the other side of the curb. Just rode up over it.
It's like it's got a lump in the actual curb, isn't it?
Yeah.
Like just watching YouTube. Man, them super noodles smell well good, don't they?
I don't know, I can't smell them.
Oh, my daughter's cooking super noodles.
Shit.
Oh, that smells really good.
Right.
P5, mate.
Yep, that's not bad. Fairly happy with that. I am now going to go to the loo, so be right back a second.
10-4. Yorkie, you better not be shaking. Matt. That's over there. Yorkie, where are you? I was worried you were shaking. Just like, don't, just let it drip, mate. Just come.
One left green, line up on the left side. Pit road is closed right now.
Oh, bloody hell, 75 cars. 75 FPS, sorry.
I'm gonna go into chopper. Get on the chopper!
Ladies and gentlemen, everyone, good luck, good luck!
619 cars.
Alright, here we go.
Well, in qualifying, that was quite close, man.
Thanks very much. Glad it actually went pretty well.
Yeah, just got to keep it clean now, we'll be alright. Wow, who give you them?
Here we go. Halfway through that formation lap.
I put myself on push to talk now, mate. So if I don't answer when you say something, it's because I forgot to push the button, right?
Cool. Sounds good. You're. Right, 12 hours of racing. Soon about to begin on this fantastic Sebring circuit. It's a track that I very much enjoy. It's a shame it's completely flat, but it has a fantastic flow to it. It's great for racing, and it's very, very good for multi-class racing as well. As you can hopefully see, it stands in the top right. There's three classes. That's the GTPs. And you've got LMP2 cars, and then also the GTD cars as well.
Yeah, last one for me, mate. Good luck. And yeah, I'll give you a shout out if there's any issues.
Cool, thank you very much. And good luck to you as well. But yeah, hopefully we can have ourselves a good race here. As we now prepare for the start of the race. Here we go. Underway for 12 hours. Hopefully it doesn't get too messy here in the first corner. Thanks very much, Vital. I shall try to. I hope you enjoy the race and I hope you enjoy the stream as well. Indeed, Vito, it is a multi-class race.
Yeah.
trying to take it easy here for the first couple of laps, let the temperature in the tyres build up, get them up to temperature and the right sort of grip levels. Every stint is going to be 2 hours. So, well, we're triple stinting. So, a stint is actually 40 minutes, there or thereabouts. But I'm going to be doing the first three stints, then Nate will be doing three stints. And each triple stint equates to 2 hours. It's probably different per team, Vital. There'll be other teams out there with two drivers. Some have three, others may have four. You can have anywhere between 2 to 16 drivers per team. But for a 12-hour, you don't need 16 drivers. Hey Alice, hope that's going alright. Yeah, 16's way too many. Barely get any time in the car.
So out of the field, there's six teams in our category that have got three drivers.
Is everyone else too many?
Yes, mate. I was waiting for you to get out of sequence corners.
Thank you.
some GT3 stopped up ahead. Might be alright, but I just need a little warning.
Copy that.
Hey, Mac. Yeah, ECC is my favourite at the moment.
And mate, leader's just gone past the first GT3.
Copy.
And no, Mac. Gran Turismo doesn't really interest me.
Jesus, that was close.
Yeah, I don't know what he was thinking.
Yeah, that guy behind, just be careful of him, mate. He's an idiot.
Yeah.
I can see from the chopper cam that that gap was closing and he just went through it.
Or at least he tried to.
Yeah.
I saw him coming as well.
Oh my god, he nearly took the other car out then.
Yeah, I saw. Go on, you go. Seeing as he's so desperate.
He will not make it to the end of the race, mate. He's going to get damaged.
Yeah, I reckon so.
Looks like he's well overdriving it.
Yeah, don't worry, but I'll get him at some point.
Maybe worth saving a little bit of fuel, mate, trying to get 15 laps, sort of 14.8.
Copy that. Stick.
Doing great, mate, doing great.
Thank you. Feels very good so far.
Like, P1 is rapid.
Yeah, it seems like he's proper checked out off into the distance. What lap times are they doing?
Leading on a 44.3, second 44.8, third 44.7. Done a 44.1 that lap. Nice lap by yourself, though, mate.
Thank you. Got very close to the wall on the inside of turn one there as well.
P2 to P8, I think we're all very, very close on what lap time we can hit. So IPM Gold from P2 pinched the rear brakes going into the hairpin.
Yeah, I wondered what happened there. So I heard the call for a slow car. Saw the puff of smoke.
Yeah, I saw the smoke from the camera, I didn't know what it was.
Thank you. How are we doing on fuel? How are we doing on fuel?
Yeah, you still got fuel in the tank, mate.
Funny.
Nah, I don't know. You just give me, when you go over the start finish line, mate, just give us a shout of what, how many laps you got left. It's mine to get off.
Estimate 8 for the moment. 7.9 now. That's a little close. That was horrible and massively awkward.
Clear on the right.
I wonder if it's maybe worth just sitting behind him and doing some lifting post.
Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do.
See if we can get that extra lap. save some fuel, build some battery, boom.
Yep. That's the plan. Did he touch that inside wall then? He got very close.
We're very close to that extra lap, mate.
Copy that. Did he touch the inside wall on that last lap? Inside of the final corner, it looked like he got... Yeah, car in front. We got very close. Yeah, exactly, Vival. That's what I thought. Or he quite quickly unwound the steering wheel as he realised he was getting very close. Hey, Urban. Thank you very much. We're having fun so far.
He did, but I think it was more of a net pose.
Okay.
I can't see any damage anyway.
Yeah. Hey, Luna. Hope you're doing good.
Got LMP2s within the GT3s now, be careful.
Copy, copy. It looks like I just about got the lap now. This lap will probably help even more.
Nice.
Traffic.
I just think if we can save that extra lap, it's just going to help us out a bit, innit?
Yeah, it will.
Right side. Clear on
This looks busy.
Oh my god, be careful, mate.
Yeah. Mike McKenna.
Holy.
Mike,
hell.
Thank you very much for subscribing. Nothing, don't worry, someone just subscribed and had the Discord chat open.
Doing great through this traffic, mate.
Thank you.
LMP2s are pitting as well, which is quite helpful.
Wow, way is getting busy.
One more lap, mate. Well, if you've got enough fuel. Hoping to see a lot of these cars going in now.
Hopefully.
Good job, mate, good job. Got quite a few of them in there.
Thanks, Vital. Yeah, that was pretty intense.
All ready for you, mate. Hammer time. Box, box.
Copy that.
Awesome first stint, buddy. Awesome. Try and get that extra up again next stint.
right here.
Thanks very much.
Something's happened because that fast repair motorsport was actually doing all right.
Was it? Interesting. Thanks, Henrik.
Go, go, go! Left side. Stay on the right. Still there, on the line, clear.
Good job, good job. Jesus. Just remember cold tyres.
You knocked your wheels out of alignment.
Well,
The lead is spinning now.
That's really fucking frustrating. Do you see damage on the car?
2 seconds, mate. Yes, mate.
Ah, where?
Front right, split up, and the floor on the left.
Okay, well, we haven't been showing the meatball, which is good, even though it came up saying that the tyre's been knocked out.
Yeah, I heard that. That really scared me.
Yeah, same. I'll keep going for now.
Yeah, mate, yeah, just keep going.
I'm hoping all this understeer that I'm feeling is actually
cold tyres.
Cold tyres, yeah. Ah, it's not cold tyres.
Yeah, the front right, the splitter on the front right is quite high compared to the left.
Okay, do you want to uncheck the tyres? And I'll hit this lap. And we'll get that damage repaired.
What about fuel, mate? Might as well fill it up, haven't we?
Yeah.
It's not going to be much.
No.
Tyres are off. Or did you want them on?
Off. No tyre change. Hope this damage isn't too much.
Right here.
2:45. Bloody hell.
Optionals required.
Optionals. think I just lit up the rear tyres a little bit on the cold tyres.
Yeah, cold tyres, offline, dirty line.
Yeah.
That's what it was.
That's really fucking annoying. Right, in that case, I'm going to very, very quickly go to Luke, the IB. I'm back.
We're nearly good to go.
45 seconds.
So I'm just not seeing any damage being fixed yet.
Yeah. Thirty seconds.
Okay, it's all fixed.
10 seconds. Front,
front's got the bits back.
Cool. How many laps down are we now?
Yeah, one lap at the moment, but I think it could be two.
I would have thought two, seeing as P1's just up the road.
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Two laps down, mate.
Copy that. Well, that was a bit of a bummer. Nonetheless, we shall continue to press on and see how we do come the end of the race. Obviously, long way to go still. Anything can happen between now and then.
690s in the pits as well.
Yep, see that.
I'm not sure why though. Seconds in front of us.
Copy that.
Thank you. How is the car, mate?
Car feels fine. I don't know whether it's the track state or whether there is still a little bit of lingering damage. Although, I'm guessing my fastest lap time is a 44.8.
I don't know if you're talking to me, because you're watching me.
Oh, sorry, yeah, I was. Car feels alright. I don't know if it's the track state, or there's a bit of lingering damage, I don't know. But it's my fastest lap time of 44.8.
Was that a question?
Yes.
2 seconds, I'll relate, but the left side floor is still damaged.
Right, okay.
.44628 is your fastest lap.
Okay. Yeah, car doesn't feel quite 100%. It's nearly there. Like, it drives fine. Just... yeah, don't seem to have the pace that the others have at the moment.
The other pure motorsports cars in the pit.
Thank you. One position back.
You can go for a cigarette, right? 2 minutes. Back, mate.
Back and back.
Yeah, right.
Oh, yeah. A bit like that, mate.
What, sorry? What was that, sorry?
I said, yeah, it's a bit like that.
Yeah. Still, my own stupid fault. Just a little bit too eager and ambitious.
Yeah, track's at 37.
Yeah, don't feel too bad. Considering.
Clear.
At least we're back past all the LMP2 cars now. Car's got some horrendous understeering with that, yeah, going through that.
Yeah, I don't think it's as optimal now, is it?
Nah. At least we're ahead of all the LMP2 cars now as well. That was close. Three more lights vital, and then I've got one more stint to do after that before Nath gets in the car.
Max is out the race.
It what?
Verstappen.
I want him to split.
Yeah, mate. Kick the wall on the inside of turn one, and then a little bit more. Another hit where he hit the thing, and it seems to have ripped his car off. Did you know that? If you go on entries when you're watching the sim, you can actually see if people have got a meatball.
Can you?
Yeah, I've never noticed it before.
Yeah, I didn't know that. Wait, can you see some meatball flags?
Yeah, the 92 from our class has got a meatball flag, and then Teamy, I don't know if you remember Teamy from our... Used to be on Geo. Their car's got a meatball as well. Both pure motorsport cars have got meatball.
I see.
One more lap, mate.
Copy that.
Down one lap.
P10 is 16 seconds in front of us.
Yeah, the gap to them was up at 19, 20 odd seconds at one point. Last few laps has come down a bit.
He done a 153.4 last lap, mate.
That'd be work. Ah.
You were the fastest car last lap.
Was I?
Yeah, mate, yeah. You're the only car that was in the 44s. Closest car to you was a 45.6 P2.
They've just pitted. So we're out of sync by a couple of laps to everyone else.
Don't forget to box, mate.
Yep. Right here. 0.1 seconds of optional. Hopefully that straightens out the bit on the side. Thanks for the reminder, Vital.
Tracks up at 38.
Copy that. You see the oversteer coming out the pits?
Yep.
Yep, literally just turned. That was enough. Nath, has that damage on the side of the car been fixed?
No, mate. Why?
Okay, just wondering.
It's not much, mate, it's just a little indent in the floor when you look at the other side compared to the other side.
Copy that.
What's annoying is we're actually on pace with the leaders now.
Hello, Graham. How's it going? Okay. Nice. I was not sure where he was going.
Yeah, I couldn't tell which way he was going.
Yeah. Well, that sucks. Hopefully the car passes fairly quick. Hopefully the rugby's good. Cheers for the info, Vital.
Do you want the bad news?
Hit me.
You were the fastest on the track again last lap.
How was that bad news?
Because we're so far behind.
That's good news, it means we're catching everyone else.
Yeah, but no, but. 7/10 being 2 laps down is not much.
Oh, a long race, long way to go. Didn't did he really need to do use all that room that he did?
Well, put it that way, if I was you, I would have actually held. I would have took longer to get through that right hand and really held him up. There was totally no need for what he did then.
I didn't even apologise. That's alright then, I'll let him off.
I don't know if there's something wrong with this Project Dynamic Yellow car, or they're just shit, because they're not getting under 150s.
Which car's that?
P9, mate.
Okay.
The 151.5 last lap, 53.5 the lap before.
They're 2 laps up ahead?
Nope, on the same lap.
Probably got damaged then. You're enjoying the additional info then, Vital, being able to see lap times and see the gap shrink.
Car looks fine.
Yeah, car feels fine.
No, their car, I mean.
Oh, their car, I see. I had some feedback from some viewers last time saying that it was quite difficult to follow the Daytona 24 Hours, see exactly where we were in terms of the class standings, and exactly that. So I thought having that additional info out there would be useful to a lot of you, especially in situations like this where we're not on the lead lap anymore. So obviously you can see the lap counts up there. Should be able to see that we're a couple of laps down, but hopefully the gap is coming down a little bit. There should be
the 27 seconds in front.
A delta between each of the cars, or sorry, myself and all the other cars, but then also the gap between us and the leader. Yeah, the UI on iRacing isn't the friendliest. They still doing 150s.
No, mate, nah, 49.7.
Okay, copy.
Lol. Taking 2 seconds out of them already. 20 seconds.
B. What lap times is the car in front doing? P10.
45.1.
Okay.
You're actually about the same pace.
Yeah.
Oh, watch out, that car's crashed. It's coming closer to us.
Oh yeah, that's it.
He pitted 7 laps before us.
Copy. So he's got about 7 more laps.
10-4.
We got 14 laps remaining, mister.
Yeah, I'm just gonna have a fag in that, get ready. 2 minutes.
Copy that. Good luck. Hey Darren, how's it going? Race is going okay. Made a silly mistake earlier on, which has cost us a couple of laps. Which is a bit of a shame, but we're making ground. And a move around the outside. Not gonna lie, it was a bit sketchy though, especially on the way down to the hairpin there. Oh dear, that's a Lamborghini in the wall on the right there. But that's us back up in P10. Lovely jubbly. Thank you, Vital.
top 10 height.
Indeed. Move around the outside as well. Probably would have been a corner sooner, but man decided to pinch me whilst I was up on the grass. Fair enough. An attack on the fuel, which is nice, that's wide. Don't want to do that.
Clear on the left.
Safety is vital. I think there's a little bit of time lost. About 7 or 8 attempts, but it's not too bad. Oh god, what's going on between these two cars up here?
I think that car was a bit ruined.
Was he? I didn't see how much damage he had. Car in front
is mostly going to pit 3 laps before us.
Yeah. I think they're getting a little bit agitated that E13 isn't letting them through.
P9's last lap was a 2 minute.
Incident. CMP 9 less than 5 seconds up the road. Here I'm, Jesse.
690, mate, must have damage because it's got sandwiched between a GT3 and a Dallara.
Copy that. I see him 5 seconds up the road.
Yeah, coming into this next sharp right hander, he was in the middle and he ended up hitting the wall. Making contact and hitting the wall on the left. I think he's got damage, but he's so close to his window that he's going to try and drag it out.
Yeah. Makes sense.
You got 5 more laps, mate. I'm just gonna go and have a proper look at his car.
Copy that. How's it going, Jesse?
Sorry, mate, I had a phone call.
No worries.
So yeah, the floor damage that we've got, he's mostly got triple the amount on the same side.
That's because there are no blue flags here, Vitus.
This guy in front should be pitting, mate. The back marker, not the actual other one. Well read, mate, well read.
Whew. Yep, saw that one coming.
That, sir, was a brilliant bit of driving.
Thank you very much. Here for another 10 hours. Not driving a little bit, though.
I clenched my bum cheek so hard then, it was unbelievable.
Yeah, it got tight.
Mate, do you want to do another stint or something?
No? Why?
Are you trying to give me a heart attack? Stop doing this stuff.
Sorry, I was expecting it to be a little bit quicker.
Two more laps, mate.
Copy that. Yeah, I was expecting it to be a little bit quicker on the exit.
So obviously you've got this car that's on the same lap as us in front of us, and then there's no one. But then we've got three more cars that are a lap down of the leader.
Okay, copy that.
So we've just got to keep hammering it.
Yeah. One more lap.
How does the track feel, mate? It's at 42.
Feels fine, to be fair. Like, sure, it's not as quick as it was, but set feels alright. It's working with it. You ready, Nath?
An apex there somewhere.
Yeah, I missed that one. You all set? Good to go?
Yeah, mate.
Cool. Be in this lap.
He's definitely got damage behind. Is that the optimal line into the pit lane, is it?
No. The rear was just wanting to wiggle a little bit.
Mate, your tyres were down to 50% on the front left last time.
Yeah. Bear in mind, I did a couple of extra laps.
Yeah.
Only that time. 54. There you go. Right. Car is yours.
Move it, move it.
Best of luck. And remember, cold tyres. Go nice and easy the first 2-3
yeah,
laps.
Right. Yeah. 10-4.
All clear on exit.
Thank you.
Remember, gravity brakes in the braking zone. You got P5 behind you.
Was that the 32 car that's just spun?
Yeah, 32 just went off a little bit. Then it just went wide.
Car on your left. Clear.
Nice. Just settle in, mate. Find that room.
Yeah, that's why I was just letting him go, mate.
Yeah. Right, there we go. Here, mate. There we go. Cool. Well, that's those two stints done. Two stints? Three stints. Shame about the incident before, but, worked out all right, eh? Have another look at the exit. That was pretty close considering. That worked out quite nicely.
Car on your left. Clear.
Whoa.
Apex is in the next state over.
Lol.
You are well wide. Hey Vital, so plans next 12 hours.
I had to feed off the brakes a bit, that's why, because it was going to lock.
Yeah, no worries. Alice's family, we're having a meal out tomorrow. Some lunch, pub lunch, which would be nice. But other than that, not really all that much. So, fairly chill weekend, I should hope. Obviously, apart from today, which is good. What about yourself? You got much stuff going on? Nice. Well, happy birthday for tomorrow. But that'd be good. Where are you going for dinner tonight? Any extravagant restaurants or anything? And also, what is it you're coding? Restaurant, good. Okay, nice. Very good. What's the website you're working on? Sounds pretty good. I don't know much about websites myself. Well, in terms of like building them and stuff. That sounds pretty good. Is that for work or is it? Well, you said it was coding session. Or is it, is it work or are you doing like a course or something? Possibly some educational stuff. Okay, cool. Nice little hobby, I guess. That's good. People will go get their food. Speaking of which, I'm probably gonna go grab some lunch in a second. Alright, I'm gonna pop away for 5 minutes or so, sort myself some lunch, and then I'll be back.
Okay, mate.
Cool. Settling, doing good so far. Hey, Derek! Fortunately, you've not quite got me at the right time. I'm just about to go make myself some hot crust buns, and then I shall be back to have lunch and obviously continue cheering Nath on. So give me a couple of minutes. I'll be back in a minute. Moment.
Clear.
Okie dokie, we are back. And we have some lovely, very tasty looking hot crust buns. Yes, they do look very, very good. See that knife still going? Hi, he's back.
Oh, hi. Just keeping an eye on that fast repair car at the moment.
Yeah, they're five and a half seconds behind. Lap times are fairly comparable. You were 7/10 of a second quicker on the previous lap, though.
Nice.
So gap is extending.
I ran the car across this curb though just now. Centre of the floor.
Should be fine.
That can't be worse than what you did, to be fair.
Exactly.
Lol. I couldn't finish it all in one hit, I had to let go of the button.
Hey Reinhardt. Race is going okay, thank you. Started off well, qualified P5. We dropped a couple of places. In the first stint with some battling, and then at the very beginning of the second stint I made a mistake on cold tyres, which gave us some damage and put us two laps down. But we're continuing to push on. We made up a few places and then we've gone from P12, P13 back up into where we are now, P9. But we are 3 minutes and 20 odd seconds behind P8, so a couple of laps, which is a little bit of a shame, but nonetheless, we'll see what we can do, see if we can close up to them a little bit. Still, long, long way to go, as you can see. 9 hours, 20 odd minutes. All right, Vital. Thanks very much for tuning in. Hope your coding continues to go well, and yeah, hopefully I'll see you later on. If I don't, have a good evening. Enjoy your meal out, and of course, have a good birthday tomorrow. Very happy birthday to you. But yeah, thank you very much for tuning in and saying hi. Hanging in the chat. Been awesome talking to you. Exactly, Reinhardt. That is the plan.
How are we lapping this car already?
They appeared not too long ago, I think. I think after I passed them, not long after that, they pitted. That's really unfortunate, Reinhardt. Fortunately, it seems that some do like to go a little bit too aggressive right at the start. Ridiculous. I really do wish iRacing would actually do something about the rolling starts, because they are far too free of rules and any penalties. People really take advantage of it. The gaps that you have between different classes that people make is often far too big. Sometimes you get scenarios like that where people go and then stop, either because they've gone too early and caught up with the back of the pack, or they're just trying to dummy the cars behind and create such dangerous scenarios. Sounds pretty good. And I just had some hot cross buns, and I'm eating some crisps. Very extravagant and healthy. Simple man. Exactly, Fudo the champion.
Holy shit.
You hit the apex of the last corner.
Who?
You. Still waiting for the fuck off.
That was your fuck off.
Well recovered. Just caught the grass. Oh no! Is that a toe? Yep, that's a toe. Fuck.
So sorry, mate.
That's alright.
I think I've done the gearbox, man. Fuck's sake! Really let off then, because I thought I'm going to go on the curb. Yeah, I think that's me fuck the race over now, mate.
Did you get that?
Yes, Harry, I done that tyre. Alright, mate, don't make it any worse.
Wicked. You didn't even go over the the curb.
It just bit me, mate. That's what I mean. I even let off the throttle.
Yeah.
I thought, I'm running deep. I've let off the throttle. I'm off the throttle as I hit the curb. Yeah. It's like my tyre got stuck on the other side of the curb. Innit?
But it didn't.
Or mine, it did.
Oh, it did for you?
Yeah.
Ah, okay. Yeah, you see the sparks on my screen. You're up on the curb, and you see the sparks as if you dropped to the other side, and you just spun you around. How long on the repair?
Minutes.
Damn.
So sorry, mate. The worst thing is I don't get it, mate, because... let me take my thing... Let me take this off the bloody system, and that's the oldest button. Yeah, it's really weird, mate. I don't know if you notice, like literally, as I'm about to hit the apex of that corner, the left rear is leaving a tyre mark on the track. There's like a rubber line going down from where I've been. And then it's just like, it's understeering. I'm turning and it's not going. All right, mate. I hit that side of the curb, yeah.
Did you say the left rear or the right rear? I'm not left seeing anything on mine.
Come on, I have got my screen going.
I've got a screen share.
Yeah. Has, stop a minute, mate. Tell me when you're here.
I'm there.
Can you see this tire mark?
1 second.
I think it's on one simulator, so you might not be able to see it all.
Yeah, no, I see it.
You see it?
Yeah.
Look, it starts here. And I just get this. Look how much I'm turning. Off the
floor. That's your front left.
And then, boom, on the other side of the curb. I've got full brakes on. I'm trying not to hit the wall. And then, yeah.
You have to just turn down the gear.
Alright, I'll ask your advice next time.
So you got a new race engineer.
He's pointing at all the curbs and the walls and everything.
Is he?
Well, if I teach you.
What do you mean?
But yeah, that.
Just this side of the
curb. Did he say I teach you?
Yeah, he said I teach you. This is what I have to live with, mate, honestly.
That's brilliant.
No, Harry.
You have to turn this down and then turn. And then boom.
What do you want to do, mate?
Oh, I don't know. I can see what the car's like after 40 minutes. I mean, that's going to be us down, but. I mean, there's no way in hell that we're going till 4 in the morning between the two of us.
Slippery goddamn way!
Well, I don't mind doing. I don't mind doing the later bit.
You need to skip that bit.
Nah,
I don't. Just means you'd have to do more. You'd have to do more during the evening.
Yeah, I'd prefer not. To be fair,
that's fine.
Just because. I don't think Alice would be too happy, and we've got plans tomorrow. Plus, I'd like to be there for the whole 12 hours as well, rather than disappearing.
Yeah.
That's the thing. If it was a 24-hour race, then yeah, I'd probably be up for doing it. Actually, no, I won't be able to do tomorrow anyway.
You see?
Never mind.
This bit here is from the...
But yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, we're going to be so down, I think. I don't think the car's going to get prepared properly.
Yeah, I reckon we're probably going to be a good 26 or so laps down.
I'm saying it wouldn't even go into gear, mate. Well, it went into gear, just didn't have no drive. I've done the drive shaft.
The left rear tyre was basically detached from the drive shaft, which is why, yeah, I didn't move.
Can I play your iPad, mate?
No, I want to. I want to show you some pictures. You hit that.
Yeah, 6 minutes left of required, 30 minutes of optionals. Oh, I can't believe I did that! I've not once done that at all in practice or anything. Why are you copying me?
Ah, oh, so unlucky.
Do you think it's because what did I do before that? I spun, didn't I?
I don't think that had.
Look at my overheating my tyres though.
Maybe a tiny bit, but I don't know. It was my more front... the rears that would have overheated.
Look, my front left already, 59%. Yes.
59. Imagine it was 7 weeks.
You were quite a way into the stint. I don't know how many laps you had left, but
not sure, mate. Do you?
I think you had about 9-10 laps left.
Oh, it's so frustrating. Yeah, watch Mummy's Cup. Sorry to all your viewers that come to watch a race.
It's alright. I was just super unlucky with that curve. Even I had the funny bounce on it in qualifying.
Yeah, well, I've been across it, mate. Like, literally grinding across it like a skateboard rider. I think it's because I tried to come off of it, which is what caused the issue.
Maybe, but you only just dropped the other side of it. It's not like it was clear that you were gonna...
I don't mean it has.
...go and straddle it.
Yeah.
So, it makes sense that you try and pull the car back onto the racing line.
Yeah, hindsight would be just bloody turn left straight away.
Yeah, but... hindsight is this...
wonderful
mythical,
thing.
...mythical, magical, yeah. Yeah, that's really unfortunate. I think that's probably race done, to be fair.
Just come from this angle and then what?
Watch your mother.
He's still teaching her how to drive.
He's now pulled mum's eyes over and like, look what dad's done.
Oh no.
Yeah.
Yes, has.
You take a picture of that?
No, I'm not taking a picture of it. Get out of here, mate.
He's just trolling you.
Getting trolled. Trolled by a 4 year old, mate.
Yep.
Oh, look, now I bet we're near enough in the bloody... we're going to be behind the GT3 cars.
Yeah, we will be.
It's not even started on the optionals yet. Same, mate.
Unlucky, dude. That was unfortunate. I don't know what else you could have done.
Yeah. I just don't think I was used to these. Maybe it was these conditions with the front left going up quite a lot. Well, I was too much of the tyre, and that's why it was understeering like it was.
Yeah. And conditions are quite hot, aren't they? Were they? 45. We were not practicing at 45 degrees.
There's no double, mate. Can't go nowhere, mate. It's not fixed. So are we calling it, mate?
I think so. I think so.
Do you know what's the weird thing?
What's that?
The floor's fixed itself.
Is it?
Yep.
That's good to know.
What, that you have to hit the rear at like 40 minutes worth of damage to get the side to fix itself?
Yeah. Sounds about right though. Sounds like iRacing things.
Yeah.
That is weird.
Okay.
Right.
Alright. Be right back then. See you in a sec.
Yeah.
No, you can play my car with me.
Well, that's really unfortunate. Yeah, that really sucks for Noth. I feel for him, because it doesn't look like he really did too much wrong there. Like, he hit the apex. And as you said, I think he may have just been turning a little bit too much tire wear, and the car just understeered slightly, and then a really weird reaction over the curb as well. Not sure what exactly happened, other than I guess him maybe dipping the wheel over the other side. Obviously we didn't really see that on our screen, but we kind of saw it there on Nath's. So yeah. That is a bummer. Obviously, not how we wanted the race to go at all. So I feel absolutely gutted for him, because he'll be kicking himself. And obviously, his four-year-old son Harry is not helping either, by rubbing it in a little bit and obviously trying to school him a little bit on how to drive and what he should have done and all that sort of stuff. Obviously, young Harry is a race engineer or motorsport aficionado in the making. Good to see the passion there already at quite a young age. But yeah, that is going to be it, unfortunately, for our Sebring race. A real shame, but thank you nonetheless for coming along and supporting, joining us for the first three and a half hours or so. Yeah, 3.5 hours racing action. But hopefully, next time we can do a lot better for you. The next race is actually going to be the Nürburgring 24 Hours in May. And planning on doing something a little bit special that I haven't done before. Racing with the community. So if you fancy potentially racing with me and some other people from the York Sports Racing Discord, as it were, or my Discord, then feel free to click the link down in the description below. Join us, and I'll be putting up details there in due course as to when it comes round towards the Nürburgring 24 Hours. We'll set up some practice sessions, we'll do some practicing together, hopefully help people improve their overall driving, and hopefully I can run a couple of cars under the York Sports Racing name, which would be very cool, and it'll be a first time. So if you fancy getting involved, feel free to join my Discord. But otherwise, thank you very much for watching. I'll try and get an actual video out this week, possibly with some LFM or something like that. We shall see. But in the meantime, have fun, stay safe, and take care.